Southern California's Inland Talk Express is KCAA News Talk 1050.
That's right. Welcome back to the Live with Aaron and Kelly. We have with us Miss Trinity. How are you?
Thank you for coming on.
I know. Now, Trinity, I've known you for a few years now, but how did you get started in the music industry?
Rather randomly, my sister's boyfriend at the time, I was about 15, and he was making music. He had a new studio. He said, "Can you just test this mic out for me?" So I started singing on it. He was like, "Oh, you actually have quite a nice voice." And so he started paying for me to have singing lessons.
Well,
random
that's nice.
Beginning to my career. But yeah, that's how I began singing. And that led actually to a record deal, believe it or not.
Wow.
Back then. And did that. It was actually successful. It was actually on the dance charts on Billboard.
Oh my gosh.
But my parents were like, "Okay, enough of that. Back to school. Back to reality." So I had to graduate from college before I was allowed to come back and pursue it again.
Okay.
And so that's what I did. I moved to LA after I graduated from college and been in the music business now for about 10 years.
Now, your sound is kind of like a reggae, would you say? Is it reggae? How would you describe your sound?
Yeah, I call it ragga hop.
Okay.
Ragga hop?
Ragga hop.
Ragga hop.
Yeah, because it's kind of got like a reggae vibe, but then there's elements of hip hop and R&B in there. You know, it's very kind of a crossover sound.
And with the crossover sound, you are kind of mixed in your background
well,
as well.
Well, that's the thing. I'm a crossover, exactly. I'm a crossover race, breed, whatever you want. So, yeah, my father's from Trinidad in the Caribbean. My mother is actually from the East Coast in the States, but I was born and raised in England. So yeah, I'm just I'm kind of blended up my music in the same way that they blended up my blood.
Yeah, I love it.
And that's cool. You're like really big in Japan as well.
Yes,
I mean,
actually,
they love you out there.
I'm about to release my fifth album in Japan on June the 6th. It's called Ragga Lovers.
Love it.
Love songs with a ragga twist.
Very cool.
My other kind of big following is in Jamaica. The song that you just heard, If I Was Your Girl, was number one in Jamaica just 3 weeks
Congratulations,
ago.
Congratulations, by the
awesome.
Way. That's fantastic.
I love it, too. It's Thank great. You. It's very catchy. Now, as far as like advice that you can give to other people out there that are trying to get into the music industry, what would you give to them? Because you've been doing this now for a few years.
Yeah, and to be honest, I think, well, first and foremost, as an artist, you need to know who you are as an artist. Mm-hmm. I think a lot of people try and get into the industry probably too quickly. Mm-hmm. And the best thing to do is perfect your craft. And the more you do that, the more opportunities kind of start presenting themselves. Obviously, you have to put yourself out there. But with the internet nowadays, it's easier to do that. Mm-hmm. Of course, you can get your Facebook page, you can get a website, and you can promote yourself online in ways that you really couldn't do just a few years ago. And the other thing I think is probably the most powerful is to perform live. Because when people see you
that
and
is
they
so
feel
true.
Your energy, yeah. That's when you really touch people.
You connect with them.
Yeah, that's how I feel like when I hear a musician, I hear the studio version,
right.
But if I see them performing live, I sometimes even like the live version over the studio.
Exactly. And people remember, you know, they take that connection that they make when they see a live show. They take that home with them and sometimes never forget. So,
where's your favorite place to perform live?
My favorite place is Africa.
Very cool.
Why?
The people there, I mean, I've never experienced that much of a party vibe. Like, just from the first second that we got on the stage, like, they just appreciated the live music and they were so into it that it made the show even better because just the energy was crazy. And that's, like, I've been to now Tanzania, I've been to Rwanda, Ghana.
Wow.
Like a lot of different countries in Africa.
But the Tasmanian devil doesn't belong in Tanzania, right?
No,
that's from Australia.
No. That's on a different
Sorry.
Continent.
That's a whole nother, that's G4. That's a whole nother network with comic books and video
games.
Hey,
I like my
Tanzania.
Tanzania.
East Africa.
Okay. I got it.
We need to take a trip to Africa.
I do. I need
that
to get a little.
Fun.
Yeah, I need to get a little bit more.
We need to get a little bit more worldly.
Country, yes.
Country.
Country. Country-ish. Go around the world.
That's hilarious. Now, talk a little bit about the album that's going to be released in Japan. Now, it's a little different than
it
some of the stuff.
It is a little different.
Okay.
This album is actually a cover album of Japanese pop songs.
Okay.
So basically, I was sent a bunch of famous Japanese pop songs that have been famous for some recently, some years ago, and I had to translate them. Well, I didn't personally translate them. They sent me the literal meaning. I had to write lyrics, though, in English.
Was that difficult?
It was, because It seems, I don't speak any Japanese really, but it seems like it takes a lot more syllables to make the same meanings in Japanese. So they would send me stuff and what the meaning was compared to how much time it took up on the song. I had to add a lot of things.
Oh, wow. So you know, it's, in English it's shorter in other
words. Yeah, exactly. It's a lot shorter in English. And also the way they talk, like the way they write, it's very poetic.
That's like French, I feel like.
It's like, it's kind of not what, it, like here it wouldn't be considered cool.
Right.
So I had to
kind
of...
more choppy. Like
yeah. And like not no slang. I mean, obviously maybe that was the translation, but I had to kind of coolify it a little bit.
Uh-huh.
Especially because I was trying to put my like ragga influence into
it. Right, a little bit of soulful vibe.
Yeah, I wanted a soulful vibe and I wanted to add a bit of patois too. Mm-hmm. So it was a challenge, but I think it came out really well. Very so I did nine songs, Japanese pop songs, and one English cover they asked me to do. I Will Always Love You. Can you believe that?
Wow.
I was so petrified.
That's like, hello.
I've sung many Whitney songs in my bedroom.
Right.
But to sing a Whitney song like out in public, that's a whole nother
thing. How did you do that? I mean, like... I wouldn't even. I know where to begin.
Yeah, I would be. I mean,
yeah.
I've heard you sing.
Well, I. Yeah.
Which is not that. And she,
it's horrible. Horrible.
It was a challenge for two reasons. One, obviously, because it's literally the hardest song for a vocalist to sing ever, like in every way. But secondly, because it was over a kind of reggae beat, so it was a lot far, the tempo and the rhythm was a lot different from the original.
Mm-hmm.
And we've all heard the original so many times and it's stuck in our heads.
Yes.
So I had to kind of like twist it, make it my own. And actually, I like it. Like, it turned out well, considering. Of course, I don't sound like Whitney.
But do you really want to? I mean, nobody wants, like, a duplicate.
Yeah. Of course.
Like, I don't want to be like Aaron.
Yeah.
And Aaron doesn't want to be like Whitney.
Right, right, yes. You could
never be like Aaron.
Oh, Lord.
Sorry.
I brought it to a different vibe, and I think it's cool.
Cool.
The fact that I sang it.
Did you like that process, like having to do like covers in a different language, and then also, you know, like, did you enjoy that, or do you prefer to do your own?
You know what? It was actually kind of cool because I've always done my kind of style. It's not as like as a vocalist.
Mm-hmm.
My style isn't. It's not like these big powerhouse songs.
Mm-hmm.
But this is. This Very is the cool. first time that I've ever had to do powerhouse songs on record. And so that was a real challenge, but I embraced it. It was great. It was really, really fun, actually.
And you recently had a song, which is kind of cool because I know one of the actors on the show, Zooey Deschanel's show New Girl. You actually had a song on there,
right? Oh, really?
Right? Yes. So tell me a little bit about that. And you're kind of like writing music for television and film now. Talk about that a little bit.
I am. Like, I've written probably about 20 songs now that have been placed in many, many things. There's been that show. There was a song placed on Glee.
Oh, cool.
A lot of commercials. I just recently got a Colgate commercial, Walmart commercial. So, you know, that side of the business is something that a lot of artists need to get into because, quite frankly, the music business, the way it is now with CD sales
that
have dropped so much, you have to find other ways to make your music pay your bills.
How do you do that? How do you get to that? Is it just meeting the right people?
With the TV and licensing world, it is kind of like you have to meet the right people. Mm-hmm. But, you know, you got to get your foot in the door somehow.
And obviously you have to learn how to write music.
Well, yeah, that too.
Right. I mean, there's some singers out there, right, that don't write. They have writers for them.
Yeah,
exactly.
So, but you actually write music as well.
Yeah, and the cool thing is, like, now I'm getting the opportunity to write in all different genres because, you know, my stuff is cool for some instances. But, like, for the New Girl ad, it was a really poppy, happy song.
Very cool.
And that's cool. Like, it opens me up creatively. And I get to do all sorts of stuff.
So if you were to do a song on Kelly and Aaron, what would it be about?
Can I come back to you with a song next week, maybe?
Wow!
That would be awesome.
You guys should have your own song.
Oh my god, that would be our intro.
Your own song.
No, we don't.
I will make you your own song.
Is capping. This is
he loves it. This is a moment in history.
How cool would that be to have our own little?
I didn't
intro
expect that. I just meant like a little tiny rhyme, but I'll take a whole
we'll
song.
We'll totally take that. That's yeah. awesome.
Well, we're gonna keep you here. Okay, we're gonna keep yes. you here because we got to go to a break right now,
okay.
And then we've got Moo Faces coming back with us. We're gonna talk about Moo Faces, a little bit about music and how that all ties in. We're gonna be right back. Just stay there, and we'll be right here.
Back.
Sun tan lotion, rub down your body, put your